I've been coordinating this project, which is supported by the IDRC, which is basically on decentralization and women's land rights, to see how decentralization is mediating women's land rights, the impact of the decentralization of land services to the local level, and what it has meant for women, the successes and the deficits, and what needs to be done. We looked at women's organizing capacities and how they are able to engage institutions at local level with regard to their land rights. And also we looked at the emerging cultures around land rights within the context of decentralization. We talked to individual women, and some of them really had very moving stories, either of success or failure in terms of seeking land rights vis-a-vis the land structures. In one court session, for instance, a woman was just alone, and it was adjourned, the session was adjourned because she didn't have witnesses. And a day after, we followed her to her village, and people gathered and they talked about how she has suffered. And we asked them, you have all this knowledge, why don't you accompany her to the sub-county and give testimony and evidence? They say, we don't. For us, we only help here. But when it goes to the sub-county, we don't want to get involved. First, it is expensive. Two, it is time wasting. Three, it is dangerous. You can be waylaid on the way. So that's why you see that then movement building is very important, to be able to move these land claims from the individual women to something collective, something in the public domain. When you talk about decentralization, you find that people get divided into two camps. One camp is a proponent of decentralization, it's a good package, everything rosy about it. And the other one completely dismisses it as a painkiller, which does not address fundamental issues. And for us, we are saying that decentralization should not be seen as a package. It should be seen as a process that needs to be democratized. Because if you give us a choice, for instance, it's Shaban from Tanzania, or from Uganda, to say, is it better to centralize or to decentralize? I think one would say decentralization has a value if only these gaps and deficits can be plugged, because decentralization enables citizens, especially women, to engage with state processes and thereby to build their citizenship in a much more fundamental way.